Hello everyone. This session will see the conversion of NFA to DFA, and the method that we are going to use is called subset construction. The reason why we want to convert an NFA to DFA is to prove that NFA and DFA are equivalent. In the sense, like when you take a problem or when you consider a language, if for that language, if you can construct an NFA, then surely there exists a DFA for the same language. Okay, so we say that NFA and DFA are equivalent. Now, NFA is one where from a state on an input, you may have zero or more transition. For example, consider the given NFA over here. The input symbols are A and B. And here Q naught, when the input is A, we have two possible transition. One stays in Q naught and one move to Q1. Q naught, when the input is A, it stays in Q naught, or either it will go to Q1 also. And similarly, in state Q1, when the input is A, we don't have any transition. So this is a case we call it as NFA. And DFA is one where from each and every state on each and every input symbol, we exactly have one transition. Okay, so now we are going to convert this NFA to DFA. The method used over here is called subset construction method. Okay, so the step one over here is, first step, we have to write all possible subset of the state. Okay, here Q is a finite set of states which contain Q0, Q1 and Q2, and we are going to write the subset for this Q, and the subset starts with null and then Q0 alone, Q1 alone, Q2 alone, and then two combination, Q0 with Q1, Q0 with Q2, then Q1 with Q2. So these are all the possible two combination, 0 with 1, 0 with 2 and 1, 2. And then the last set is 3 set as a whole. So this is the possible subset of the given set of states of the given NFA. Okay, so we are going to write the all possible subset, and you remember that number of possible subset for a set is, like if set contains n element, then there are 2 power n possible subsets over there. So here the set contains 3 elements, so 2 power 3 is 8, so we should have 8 possible subsets. So here it is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. So we have all the 8 possible subsets, and it starts from null state. Okay, so this is the first step. For the given set of states, we are going to write all possible subsets. Okay, and the second step is to draw the transition for the given states. Step 2 is to form a transition table for all the subsets over here and the inputs over here. Okay, the transition for Q0, Q1, Q2 will be taken from the transition diagram. See, we have a transition diagram of NFA. From this NFA, we are going to write the transition for Q0 on AB, Q1 on AB and Q2 on AB. And the remaining things will be filled by the combination. Okay, so we start with this transition of Q0 when the input is A. Q0, when the input is A, we have two possible transition. So one stays in Q0 itself and one goes to the state Q1. So it is Q0, Q1, and transition of Q0 when the input is B. Q0, when the input is B, we have a self flow, so the transition goes to Q0. And similarly for Q1, when the input is A, there is no transition, so we make it as null set. And when the input is B, it goes to the state Q2. And in Q2, there is no transition, so it is null transition for both the case. Okay, so this set for Q0, Q1 and Q2, we have taken the transition from the transition diagram given over there. From the diagram, we have copied it. And for null, you make the transition on input on A and B as null transition again. And the remaining set, when the transition for Q0 and Q1, when the input is A, we have to combine Q0 and Q1 transition altogether. So here it is Q0, Q1, and here it is null transition. When you combine both, you will have Q0, Q1 over here. And similarly Q0, Q1, when the input is B, we have to combine Q0, Q1 transition when the input is B. So it is Q0 and Q2. So we have to fill Q0 and Q2. Q2 over here. Okay, and similarly for Q0, Q2, combine Q0 and Q2. Here it is null. So here we have Q0 and Q1. So we will have Q0 and Q1. Okay, and over here what happened when you combine Q0 and Q2? Here it is null, and here we have Q0. So we have to write Q0 transition over here. Okay, and for Q1, Q2. Again, we have to combine the state Q1 and Q2 altogether. So here it is both the case it is null. So make it as null transition. And here we have Q2 transition. Q2 combined with null, it is Q2 transition. Okay, and for Q0, Q1 and Q2, we have to combine this Q0, Q1 and Q2 altogether. So it is null, null, Q0, Q1. So it will be Q0 and Q1. And here on B transition, Q0, Q2 and null. So it will be Q0 and Q2. So this is how we have to fill the transition table. Now these things we have copied from the given NFA. Okay, the second step is like we have to mark, we know that Q0 is the starting state, so we have to indicate this Q0 as the starting state, and Q2 is the final state. So wherever you have Q2, you have to mark that as a final state. Wherever we have Q2, we have to make that as a final state. Okay, so whenever it is an NFA or DFA, in the transition table we have to mention the starting and final states, and there is only one starting state, whereas the final state might be n number. Okay, so wherever you have this Q2, since Q2 is the final state of the given NFA, we are going to mark, wherever you have Q2, we are going to mark that as the final states. Okay, so this is your step 2, and step 3 is we are going to give a new name for each and every subsets. Okay, we can start from the null state. I can give null as A and this as B, C, D, E, F, G and H. Okay, for each of the subset, we are going to give a new name for it. Okay, and we are going to rewrite the transition table in the given new names. Okay, so the transition table, after renaming, you'll get a transition table in the new names. We are going to rename the given table. So wherever you have this null transition, I just made it as all A's. Okay, see, we have a null over here, so we have made it as A. And Q0, we are going to make that transition as B. So similarly for all the sets, when it is Q0, Q1, I have given the name as E. Q0, Q1, that set is given a new name with E, so we can add this E over here. Okay, so now this is a table where I have renamed all possible subsets, but when you look into this and we have to mark the starting and final states. So whereas Q0 is the starting state over here, and we have given B as a name for Q0, so here state B act as a starting state, and state D, F, G and H, D, F, G and H will other sets that contain Q2 over here. So these states will act as a set of all final states. Now when you look into this table, like for you have these things as state and A and B as input, capital A to H as the states. From each and every state, on each and every input symbol, we exactly have only one transition. Okay, see, all the places there is no null transition, there is no combination of the sets. In each and every place we have a single state as a transition. Okay, so we call this as a DFA. But the problem here is we have considered an NFA with 3 states actually, and we have derived a DFA with 8 states over here. Okay, so this thing has to be eliminated. The state, the unwanted state has to be eliminated from this place. Okay, so in order to eliminate this unwanted states, we are going for the next step. In order to eliminate all the unwanted states, we are going to rewrite the table which starts from the starting state. The transition over here, we are going to start from the starting state. B is the starting state over here. So we are going to take this transition of B and write it over here. The reason why we start from the starting state is whenever we want to process an input in case of a NFA or DFA, the processing starts with the starting state. So whichever state that are reachable from the starting state are the only states that can stay over here. Okay, the remaining states are unreachable and unwanted states, and we will eliminate it. So we start with the starting state B, B, when the input is A, we are going to the state E, and when the input is B, we are going to the state B. Okay, so here we got a new state E, and we have to write the transition for E. So we are going to find all the reachable states from the starting state. Okay, so the transition for E is, when the input is A, it stays in E. When the input is B, it goes to a new state F. Okay, state E, when the input is A, it goes to E, it stays in E itself, and when the input is B, it goes to a new state F. Okay, so now we got a new state over here F, and we have to write the transition for F. And while writing the transition for F, note that F is a final state, so we have to copy it in the same case. So F will be a final state, and the transition on A, it goes to E, and transition on B, it goes to B. So it is E and B. And E, we already have a transition for this. This state is included, and B state is also included. So these are all the only state that are reachable from the starting state. We have E, E's transition is written, B, B transition is written, again E transition is written, F transition is written. Okay, so this is the final DFA for the given NFA. So this process we call it as subset construction method, conversion of an NFA to DFA using subset construction. Thank you.